Amen. Bless them. The power of the Holy Spirit. Let the power of the Holy Spirit empower their life. And you know, I believe this season is a season of God's goodness. And God is mastering an army. God is raising an army, preparing for a greater purpose. We need to understand, you know, the great, you know, nuclear bombs are not created, outside. You know, the greatest, the powerful, most powerful weapons, the bombs are not created like crackers, which is made in streets or in a small scale industries. So the major, the very important, or the nuclear weapons are being created, made in secret places. So I believe this lockdown season, God has locked us together with Christ so that we can become a mighty exploits for the kingdom of God. So we are in the absolute plan of God. We are in God's timing. So something supernatural our nations are going to see. So I'm so excited about this season. You know, 2020 is going to be glorious. It's going to be glorious. You know, we have at a time, you know, we know we are in the sixth month. Amen. And God is moving so powerfully. This month the Lord gave the promise like that. The angel of the Lord was sent to the city of Nazareth. Amen. To the house of Mary, the mother of Jesus, to make her a history. Amen. So that the world will look at Nazareth in a different way. And the world will know the Savior lives. Hallelujah. So I believe sixth month is so much glorious for God's children. You have a message from heaven. Your hope will never go in vain. And God is doing supernatural glorious things in our life. So be excited. Get encouraged through the Word of God. Excited for the Word of God. I'm always excited, you know, whenever I preach or whenever I hear the Word of God, whenever I read the Word of God, whenever I hear from Jesus, I'm excited. Amen. The people who are excited, amen, will see supernatural things in their life. God is going to do supernatural things in our life because He is concerned about our life in a greater way. That's the reason. He is concerned. We need to understand God is concerned about our life, you know, the way the Peter dealt with Jesus was so evident. We could see, understand more about the excitement of the word. When Jesus was walking on the water, everybody, the disciples, everybody saw, but Peter made a very different statement. He said, Lord, if it is you, I'm so excited, I wanted to walk. So because he was excited, when Jesus saw him so excited about his word that proceed from the mouth, I wanted to tell you, amen, the Bible, the Holy Bible says, amen, he began to walk on the water as Jesus was walking. He became a miracle. I wanted to encourage my people of God who is watching me this morning. God wants us to be a miracle in this season. God wants us to be excited before the word. Amen. Be trembled before the word. Fear the word. Have a reverential fear in the word so that God can work, amen, through our life. Amen. It is very important. It's very important. Amen. We need to be loyal to God. We need to be aware, available for God. We need to be aware about this season. And, you know, when we understand I am the answer for this season. When you understand that you are very much important for this revival. When you understand, amen, you are going to play a major role in this season of revival. I want to tell you, you cannot keep quiet. You will be excited always. So let's start today's meditation. As we all know, like, this is the third day we are meditating about the different seven different mountains from the Word of God. So God is giving different insights from that. God is giving different thoughts and revelations from that. I believe we don't walk by sight, we walk by faith. Since we walk by faith of the Word of God, we have an answer for all of our questions from the Word of God. So when we, you know, we need to put the Word of God into exercise. We need to put it into action every minute so that we will be able to empower ourselves with the Word of God, and we'll be able to shine for Jesus Christ, for the kingdom of God. So let's start our today's meditation. Amen. It is from Exodus chapter 3. verse 1, Exodus chapter 3, verse 1. And the Bible says, now Moses kept the flocks of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the backside of the desert and came to the mountain of God, even to Horeb. Amen. He went to the Horeb, the mountain of God. Horeb, the mountain of God. So, amen. From the word itself, we need to understand Horeb, the mountain of God. If Horeb is the mountain of God, there is going to be something. There is going to be an encounter. So I'm always excited when the men of God had encounter with the Lord. You know, the whomever had the encounter with the Lord, their lives changed. So this morning, let's pray that our life will change. We will have a divine encounter this morning. As we meditate the word of God, I pray that you will have heavenly visitations this morning. Amen. As Moses, life was transformed. It was a life transforming encounter. Amen. So that means one encounter can change a man's life. A person's life can be entirely transformed when we have an encounter with God. So I pray that that day will be this day for our life. This morning, when the Holy Spirit comes on your life, when the Holy Spirit begins to speak into your life, when the Holy Spirit encourages you, amen, you need to catch the word. You need to be hunger for the word. You know, this morning I was so excited. One of my friend, you know, he messaged me saying, you know, brother, the lockdown thoughts which you sent me yesterday, I literally ate the word. I love the phrase he used. He said, I literally ate the word. You know, God is excited about the people who are hunger for the word of God. If you really hunger for the word, you know, it's not about philosophy, it's not about some theories, it's not about something which you cannot understand or comprehend. We are speaking, you know, we are meditating, we are having a time of devotion about the life-giving word, the life-giving word, the word which can bring joy in your life, the life which can change you as a history maker. Hallelujah. So, amen. Anytime, anything can happen when you believe the power of the word of God. See, here the Bible says, amen, Moses was drawn, amen, Moses was drawn by the Lord to the mountain, amen, to the mountain of God, the Horeb. Amen. The Bible says he was, as usual, you know, this man, usually he go and he used to shepherd the flock of his father-in-law Jethro. That's what the Bible says. I mean, and Jethro was a priest in Midian, and the Bible says he was leading the flock to the backside of the desert, leading to the backside of the desert, and he came to this mountain. So what does it mean? He came to this mountain. I will put it another way, saying God was drawing him towards that. God was taking him towards that, towards the mountain to have an encounter. So this morning I wanted to tell you, it is not that we desire to receive a touch, but God is pulling you. God is pulling you towards him. God is taking you towards him. God is drawing your attention towards him. God is making you to understand the importance of you. Amen. Amen. In other words, God is taking you to a mountain experience, mountaintop experience, so that you can represent the kingdom of God. You can be visible in the world in a different aspect. You can, amen, you can bring the glory of God down, and you can be amen, blessing for the multitudes. This morning, amen, I pray that God will encounter with you. Hallelujah. As we are speaking, I pray, this is my heart's desire. Amen. Wherever you are, in your home or in your office, or where, amen, in your work, as I am, wherever you are, I pray that the power of the Holy Spirit will touch you, will encourage you, will engulf you with his glory, so that you will be made perfect, and you will be a living testimony for the kingdom of God, and you will be a planet shaker for the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. There is a mighty transfer of anointing. There is a mighty mantle that is falling upon your life that changes your life. Hallelujah. It's one thing, it is important to pray in spirit, but it is most important to be engulfed with the word of God, filled with the word of God. The word of God encourages. I mean, you know, that's why the Bible says, fill your mind with the word of God so that you will be able to overcome the tactics of the devil. You will be able to move powerfully. Amen. For the kingdom of God. Here the Bible says Moses was drawn to the mountain of Horeb. Amen. Maybe he would have crossed that place many times, and he would have noticed the mountain many times, and maybe he would have known the importance of that place. But here there was a day, the appointed by the Lord for a life-changing experience. Amen. There is a day in your life the Lord has planned to have life-changing experience. I pray that let this day be that day. Oh hallelujah, where you will have a life-changing experience. This 3rd June, I pray sincerely from my heart that you will have a life-changing experience. You will have a life-changing, amen, encounter with the Lord. The Bible says, amen, this day was a different day. The Bible clearly says he was drawn to that place and he saw something is happening. Now the Bible says, amen, he saw a burning bush. He saw a bush that is burning, and he was so excited to see what is that. He have seen lot of forest fires in his life because he was taking the sheep to, amen, into the forest, and he would have crossed the many wilderness. He would have seen lots of fires in the forest, but this experience was different because he saw the burning bush, but the bush is not being burned. He understood this is not an ordinary fire. This is not an, amen, fire of destruction. This is a fire of construction. Hallelujah. This is not a fire of destruction. This is a fire of construction. Oh, this morning I wanted to tell you, the fire of construction is coming in your life. Amen. When the Holy Spirit fire fill you, amen, it will construct things in your life. The power of the evil spirit will destroy. The power of the Almighty God will construct. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. I mean, as the Bible says, when the flame of the fire came and stood over each and everyone's head. I mean, when 120 people were at, amen, when they came together in the upper room, that flame of fire consumed every darkness in their life. It strengthened them and filled them with the power of the Holy Spirit and made them to be a testimony, made them to be a witness. I pray this morning the power of construction, amen, the fire of construction will consume you, will fill you right now, will consume everything that is not, amen, pleasing in the sight of God, and that is standing as a hindrance for God to move in your life. I pray the power of the Holy Fire will be filled in your life this morning. Hallelujah. The Bible says he was so excited, he was running towards that. Amen. He was so excited about the experience. When he was going near, the Bible says like this, he heard the voice of God. See, one thing the Lord was speaking to me is, amen, about this mountain of Horeb. It is a mountain of a great commission. It was a mountain of a great commission. Amen. It was a experience where his life was changed. It was a place. It was a mountain where, amen, there was a transfer of a heavy mantle. There, a heavy mantle fell upon his life. The Bible says in Exodus chapter 3 verse 10. The Bible says, come, I will send you to Pharaoh that you may bring my people, the children of God, out of the Egypt. You know, before that, verse 9, Exodus chapter 3, verse 9, the Bible says, and, you know, God, the Lord is telling Moses, it is me. He heard the voice of God. When he saw the burning bush, he was so excited and he was rushing near to that. The Lord was speaking to him, remove your sandals because the place where you are standing is a holy ground. So we need to understand, amen, what made the land holy? It is not about the quality of the land that made the land holy. It is all because of the quality of God who came upon the land. The land became holy. Many times we think it is all because of we, things are getting better. It is all because I prayed. It's all because I am good, things are happening. No, actually speaking, it's all because your God who is in you is powerful. It is all because the Lord who is in you is great that makes you holy. It makes you powerful. Amen, amen. And makes you to walk victoriously. Here, amen, it is not because of the quality of the land. It's all because of the quality of God which came upon the land, or which came upon the burning bush, that made the land a holy place. And Moses understood it is not an ordinary encounter, it is a divine encounter. He was so excited when he heard the voice of God. You know, this is what I love. And do you know what God says? I'm very disappointed. My heart is broken by hearing the pain and heart cry of my people. And I'm seeing them being pressed by or oppressed by the Egyptians, by the Pharaoh. But and the next word God says, so I have come down. Oh, I have come down to deliver. I have come down. See, amen. We need to understand our God is a God who comes in. Amen. Who will come down. He's not a God who sits in heavens and say, I love you so much. I want you to be delivered. I want to bless you. No. Amen. I love the way the Lord was speaking to Moses. God said, my heart was broken. My heart was in pain when I heard the distress, when I'm hearing the cry of my people. So I have come down. So the Lord says, before you came, I have come down to have an encounter with you. Understand the heart of God. God says, I have come down with my majesty. I have come down with my glory. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. This morning, the Holy Spirit is specifically telling me to tell you, God has come down in your room. Wherever you are being seated, in your home, in your place, wherever you are, that place, the presence of the Lord says, God has come down with His glory. God has come down with His majesty to have an encounter with you, so that that encounter will make you to be a witness for God. Amen. God says, I have come. God, you know, in the Bible it says, come to me, I will come near to you. But here the desire of the Lord is much more greater. I pray that that passion will increase in your life. God will transfer that pain in your heart. God will make you to understand the real essence why God has called you. I pray that even that will enter deep and deeper in your heart, and your passion for souls will increase. The pain of God's heart will be your pain. Amen. Your heart, amen. God's heartbeat will be your heartbeat. You will be able to understand the movement, the frequency of the Holy Spirit, and you will be able to stand for the kingdom of God. Amen. Here the Holy Bible says, amen. God says, I have come down. Do you know why God have come down? The Bible says like this, amen. So God says, so I have come down. So come. God is telling Moses, so come to me so that I can send you. Three things here we could understand. One, God says, I have come down. Second, God says, now you come to me. Amen. If you come to me, amen, I can send you. Hallelujah. It is not you are going alone. God says, if because I have come down, you can be confident that you can come to me so that I can send you. And you are not going to go alone. I am going to come with you. Amen. I will send you to Pharaoh that you may bring my people, the children of Israel, out of the Egypt. I wanted to tell you this morning, there is a great recruitment happening. There is a great recruitment happening. If you really desire Jesus, if you really desire for the kingdom of God, if you're really passionate for the kingdom of God, if you really want to save souls, amen, I wanted to tell you, amen, wherever you are, lift up your both hands and cry unto Jesus. Even if you are not able to, amen, I'm not asking you to open your eyes and look at this and hear my message. No, right now I want you to lift up your both hands wherever you are and say, Lord, I am ready for that. I want that anointing. I want want that power. I want the heavenly intervention right now. I want that glory to come upon my life. I want a life-changing experience. I want a life-changing experience. I don't want to be just a soothing evangelist. I don't want to be a soothing pastor. I don't want to be a so-called man of God. I don't want to be a so-called woman of God. I don't want to be named as an apostle. I want your fire to come down. Because you have come down with your power, I am available for you so that you can send me. I don't want to go alone, oh Lord. I don't want to go alone to the battlefield. I don't want to go alone with my strength. I want to go with your power. I want to go with your anointing. Amen. I am weak. I am unable. I am a person with a lot of failures, a lot of mistakes, but I want you to empower me. Come on, say that. Say that. Wherever you are, the fire of God is coming. Hallelujah. The presence of God, amen, is upon your life. Presence of the Lord is coming upon you. Amen. The Lord is touching the people right now. I sense a mighty anointing coming upon the people. The power of God is touching your hands. The Holy Spirit is touching your eyes. God is touching your power. Amen. From the head to the toe, the supernatural glory of God is being released right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Shaldhamana, ribathiyadana. Thank you, Jesus. There is an immense presence of God, immense glory that is being released right now. Take the anointing right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, there is a glory anointing. Because heaven is down in your room. God has come down with his majesty so that he can send you with the power, and he says, I will come with you. You are not going to, amen, hallelujah, you are not going to go alone. You are going to go with the power of the Holy Spirit. I know people are receiving it right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the mighty anointing upon thy people in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The Bible says like this. Amen. Amen. And God says, it is my heart. I am commissioning you for a greater purpose. Amen. In next, I want to tell you, this mountain is a mountain of exchange. You know what was being exchanged there? Amen. Moses says, I am weak. I am a man with stammering lips. The people will not hear me. The king will not hear me. God says, I am coming with you. When I am with you, you are powerful. I am coming with you. You will be powerful. And I will demonstrate my power through your life. That's what God said to Moses. You know, it is recorded in Exodus chapter 3, verse 11 onwards. And Moses is telling, but Moses said to God, who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the children of Israel out of Egypt? The Lord says, I will be with you. Why do you want to worry? And God said to Moses, amen, I am with you. And Moses is telling how the people will accept me, Lord. Not only really Pharaoh, even your people. The Israelites will not accept me because I was grown. I was grown in Egypt. They know me as a man of Egypt. How they will recognize me? When I go and tell that it is God who have sent me, they will ask you, who is that God? And God said, say, I am that I am. Oh, I love that word. God said to Moses, I am whom I am. This is what you are to say to Israelites. I am has sent me to you. I am the Lord of I am. Amen. What a name. The Lord of I am. When Moses heard that, the Lord of I am the Lord that sent you. He began to tremble. Tell me, Lord, I know that your name is powerful enough. No man can explain the power of that word. The Lord of I am. I am that I am. I am whom I am. What does it mean? I am the one who can do anything and everything for you. Amen. This morning that God says, I am, amen, sending you. I am with you. I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. I will be with you in the very end of this age. Hallelujah. The Holy Bible says, Moses understood there is a great exchange happening in this mountain. This mountain experience is not an ordinary experience. I am really being filled by the power and the fire from above. I am receiving the glory of God. My weakness is being overtaken by the strength of the Almighty God. This morning, are you saying you are weak? The strength of God is very effective in your weakness. Hallelujah. Amen. But you need to understand one glorious secret. In the new covenant, things are different, isn't it? The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 1 onwards, the Bible says, Moses was taken to the Moses went up to the mountain of Horeb or mountain of Sinai. The Bible says where he had an encounter with the Lord for 40 days. His face started to shine like God, and he began to tremble because of the glory that came upon his life. He understood he's going to be a blessing. He's going to be a blessing. But it was not a sustaining glory. In the old covenant, it was a diminishing glory, because he knew that after 40th day, he need to climb down the mountain. The moment he climbed down, things are going to be different, because that the glory that came upon his life was his body was an external glory, diminishing glory. You know, the Bible says, so he put a veil over his face because you don't want Israelites, the people of Israel, to see the glory that is diminishing away. The Bible says, amen, all because he had an encounter in the mountain of Horeb, amen, he got a hope. He got a hope. Yes, I know that God, you know, just even though it was an external glory, even though it was a diminishing glory, he got a hope that, yeah, God is with me. But you know what happening in the new covenant? The same Bible says, amen, now the glory is not external, it is an internal glory. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 16, the Bible says, we are the temple of the living God where the presence of God dwells. So in the new covenant, you know, the hope of glory is living in you. Do you know what is the difference? We need to understand, God manifested, now listen to this statement very carefully. In the old covenant, God manifested in Horeb and gave Moses a hope. And gave Moses the hope. But in the new covenant, Jesus, the hope of glory, manifested in me and made me the hope of the nation. Hallelujah. Did you hear that? In the old covenant, God's glory manifested in Horeb and gave Moses a hope. But in the new covenant, the hope of glory manifested in me, internal. Yes, Pastor, internal glory. It manifested in me and made me a hope for the nations. You are the hope of the nation. When the glory of God is in you, you become the hope of the nation. For Moses, hello, did you hear that? Are you able to understand the essence of it? For Moses, the manifested glory upon the Horeb, amen, was the hope. But for us, the hope of glory came into my life. I become the hope. I become the hope. So you are the hope of your friend. You are the hope of your family. You are the hope of your city. You are the hope of your state. You are the hope of your country. You are the hope of the world. Hello, church. I pray that God will open your eyes to understand this mystery. Amen. Amen. Never forget it. Amen. For Moses, amen, God became a hope in the mountain of Horeb. But for you, amen, God's glory, the manifested glory, amen, came into your life. It manifested in your life and you become the hope of the nation. So this morning, I'm telling you, I'm speaking to the hopes of the nation. You are the hope. Those who are watching me, you are the hope of your place. Come on. Say that, I am the hope of my nation. I am the hope of my nation. Say that. I want you to repeat that with me. I am the hope of my nation. I am the hope of this nation. What does it mean? You are the hope of the world to give a global solution. Amen. I pray that such an anointing will take over your life right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Let it be corona, let it be chaos, let it be famine, let it be drought, let it be wickedness, let it be earthquake, let it be any other thing. You are the hope of this season. You are the hope of your nation. You are the hope of the people who are suffering. You are the hope of the people, amen, who is dying. Come on. Don't withhold yourself. Please don't withhold yourself. You are the hope. You are the hope. I pray that God will open the eyes of your understanding to understand you are the hope of this situation. You are the hope of the mankind. Amen. Whether you are in America, whether you are in Kerala, whether you are in Maharashtra, or whether you are in Karnataka, wherever you are in the parts of the world, I wanted to tell you, you are the hope. Real Kamana, Shadalama, Kamariadala, Judamana, Brava Prabhaniyadala. Amen. I mean, in the unsealed realm. Yes, Pastor, Brother Unnik, that is right. Something is happening in the unsealed world today. This very moment. Amen. In the unseen world, something is supernaturally is happening beyond your expectation. Amen. Amen. If you can open your spiritual eyes to understand what is happening in the unseen world, I wanted to tell you, every powers of darkness is kneeling down. Every powers of darkness is kneeling down. Oh, hallelujah. In the spirit. Amen. You need to bring it to captivity in Jesus' name. Everything that is standing against the blessing of the nation, everything that is standing against the betterment of the nation, everything that is standing against the blessing of the land. Amen. You need to bring it under captivity because you are the hope of the nation. You are the hope of the mankind. You are the hope. Amen. That's why the Bible says in Romans chapter 8 verse 19, it says creations are eagerly waiting for the sons of God to manifest. Not the servants of God, not the apostles of God. Hey, come on, church. Not the so-called reverends. So it's not the so-called that most reverend high. No, sons of God. Become a son. Prove that you are the son of God. Prove that you are the daughter of Jesus. Prove it, because you are the hope. Prove to the mankind, prove to the nation, prove to the place where you are, prove to the sickness that you carry the power of the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Never forget this. Say, I am the hope, because Jesus became the hope of my glory. Hey, come on. Did you got it? Even there is another translation says, the hope of glory is in you. Another translation, it says like this, the hope of my glory is in me. Wow. Amen. The hope of my glory. The hope of my glory is in me, and I become the hope of nation. Amen. The hope of my glory, Jesus, is in me, and I become the hope, and I am the hope. Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ. And amen. So it is a mountain. So one thing we understand, it is a mountain of commission. It's a mountain of exchange, or by taking all our weakness, giving his strength, and sending us to the field with the power of the Holy Spirit. And third thing, it is a mountain of hope. Again, the Bible talks about the Mount of Horeb in 1 Kings chapter 19. Amen. 1 Kings chapter 19 verse 8 to 11, it talks about this man of God Elijah. The Bible says, so he got up, ate and drank, strengthened by that food, he traveled 40 days and 40 nights until he reached Horeb, the mountain of God. The Bible says, you know, this man who brought the fire of God from heaven, he killed the Baal prophets in the mountain of Carmel. Tomorrow we are going to meditate on that. Okay, Mount Carmel. Okay, that's let's just leave it like that. And he left, and he was afraid of them, Jezebel. And the Bible says he went and hid himself under a juniper tree. He said, Lord, I want to die. The Bible says the angel of the Lord came there. The angel of the Lord appeared before this man of God and gave him food and gave him water and said, hey, come on, get up, go. You need to run. The Bible says he ran for 40 days and 40 nights until he reached Horeb, the mountain of God. The Bible says like that. And do you know what he did? And he went there and he was hiding himself inside the cave. Amen. How can he hide? How can a man hide in the mountain of God? Horeb is a mountain of God. How can he hide there? Come on. Elijah, get ready. Are you hiding? Elijah of this season, are you hiding? Are you saying you lost all your hope? Are you saying, that's it? I am the only one who is left behind. Amen. Jezebel have killed all the prophets of God. Are you saying? No. Elijah, rise up. Come out of the cave. This morning, the Holy Spirit is speaking to the new covenant Elijahs. Why are you hiding? You ate so much. You drank so much. You have acquired the energy to run to the mountain of Horeb. And now you are inside the cave. What are you doing there? Do you know what God said? Come out of the cave. I want to speak to you and give you a hope again. Come out of the cave. The Bible says, and then the Lord said, go out and stand on the mountain before the Lord. He heard the voice of God. God said, go out and stand before the Lord on the mountain. The Bible says he went. Suddenly, there was a great and a mighty wind. Amen. Elijah was expecting God to speak because that was his experience before. I want to tell you, God is going to amaze you with new things. This is a prophetical word. Receive it. Don't expect God to do the same thing what he have done last. Don't expect a revival which happened in some other countries before. The revival which is going to happen in your nation, maybe you are listening from different countries, you know, I don't want to limit the message just for India. No, it's not like that. I know many other people are watching across the globe. Amen. But I want to tell you, not the revival which happened in any other place. Amen. Is going to happen the place where you are. You are going to receive something supernatural and you are the key of the revival. Because you are the hope. You are the hope. The Bible says he was waiting for God to speak to him because he saw a rushing wind, great and rushing mighty wind. And the Bible says there was no God in that. And after that, there was an earthquake. And he expected God to speak. Amen. In that earthquake. And there was also no God. And again, there was a fire, and he thought, yeah, definitely there will be God speaking, because God spoke to Moses in fire. Even God spoke to me in fire by sending the fire upon the sacrifice which I did it on the Mount Carmel. So he was expecting something which was happened before. Listen to me. He expected God to speak to him in rushing wind, great and mighty wind, and he expected God to speak to him in fire as before. He expected God to speak to him, amen, in earthquake. But all that, God was not there. God said, I'm going to amaze you with new things. God has yet another option again. I wanted to tell you, you are going to have something supernatural experience this season. After that, the Bible says, after that, hallelujah. Amen. After the fire, there was a small, gentle voice. Small, gentle whisper he heard. Elijah, don't worry. 7,000 people are there. You know, who are there. Amen. Who has not yet kissed the feet of Baal or bowed before Baal. I am powerful. I am a God of options and I am a God of solution. And do you know what God said? Now, rise up. I'm giving you another commission. You know, this mountain of Horeb is a mountain of commission. I pray that this morning you will walk into such a glorious experience. Hallelujah. The Bible says, God is telling him, go. You need to, anoint Hazael as a king over Aram and Jehu as a king over Israel again. And you need to anoint Elisha as your successor. Three great commission God is transferring to this man of God by speaking to him in a gentle voice. My precious brothers and sisters, you are the hope of the nation. As we are meditating the mountain of Horeb, I pray that God will open your eyes. As the men of God in the old covenant had powerful experience, amen, new covenant, we are so privileged, amen, the world will know that I am powerful in Jesus. I am powerful in Jesus. And the world will know. Those men of God, they were waiting for an encounter. But I want to tell you, the world is waiting for you. In the new covenant, the world is waiting for you because you are the hope of the nation. May God bless you. Amen. Be blessed and stay blessed and be safe. Tomorrow morning again, 11 o'clock. Tomorrow morning again, 11 o'clock. We are going to be back again with another thought of the leadership. Thought about the mountain, different mountain from the word of God. Till then, have a good day, blessed day. Bye, take care. And I want you to comment your experience, you know, what God has done. If you have received anointing, if you have received a special touch from God, you know, if God has answered you, I want you to just comment so that it will encourage other people also. And share to the people, let them also grow in the Lord. Let's become a blessing. Let's take over the land. You know, nothing, we are not going to give up. We are not going to, nothing less than we are going to desire. I want to take over, you know. I love the way Smith Wigglesworth, the man of God, who said a statement. I just was going through, his book. And he says, if God is not moving for me, I will move God. If God doesn't move, I will move God. What does it mean? Amen. If God is not working for me, I will make him to work. The violent shall take heavens by force. Let's become such mighty men who can do great exploits for the kingdom of God. God expects you. You are the person for this season. Till then, stay blessed. Amen.